And the ball, it bites the lane very hard, on the nose, almost Brooklyn. Oh, and a kick out of the gutter.
They all look the same on the score sheet.
And a sigh of relief there from Pam as that went down.
What a tremendous career. As I mentioned, she really left the tour in 1985 to go to work full-time for Ebonite. And I think what was really nice, too, in talking to Pam last night was the fact that she said, you know, when I was in my early 30s and on the tour, every shot was the end of the world. Every tournament, if I didn't win, I was disappointed. She said, now I've learned to accept all that. I've mellowed a little bit, and I'm enjoying playing competitively much more than I did when I was younger.
Well, a lot of the players, she has a lot of other things in her life now, and a lot of the younger players, all that they've really known in their adult life is bowling. And so to them, that is their life, and it's very critical.
And Marie gets the break on the soft 10 pin as it fell nearly forward. A double here would go a long way in pushing her towards a match with Dede Davidson. Ahead by 24. If she strikes here, it's a 34-pin advantage. And watching her last night, Jan, there were a couple of key situations when she needed strikes down the stretch, and she really made some nice shots. Oh, that one's through the nose, almost the baby split. And Maria's saying, timeout on the floor. I would have taken it, but the three-pin will work out.
And the ball's almost crossing over to the Brooklyn. Pin kicks out of the gutter, sending the 10-pin forward, touching the 3-pin, almost knocking it over. There she goes, trying to help that pin down, leaning back along with the pin, but it didn't work.
Didn't get the strike, but a big break in just leaving the 3-pin. Easier to make that, obviously, than the baby split. So Anne-Marie with a smile and a 24-pin lead as Pam Buckner heads in to the 8th frame. All right, Steve saying, just get up. Make two good shots, throw a double in the 8th and the 9th, then we'll take our chances in the 10th.
Nice that she could have him on hand here with her this week.
Wouldn't be surprised if Pamela is on ESPN again during this swing, the way she's bowling. Beautiful shot, another solid 7, and some days it's not meant to be. Those were two great shots, and she comes up with 9 counts.
She is really making excellent shots for not being on the show for almost 6 years. Really coming through under pressure, showing really what a great bowler she is.
One of the bright young executives in the bowling industry as well. She sells, I think, more bowling balls than any other salesman for Ebonite. And Bill Supper, who's vice president in charge of sales, has nothing but the best to say about Pam Buckner. One of the great people, one of the fun people, I think, in the bowling industry. And I think that's very important. It's a wonderful game. It's an entertainment game, a family game. And that's what Pam Buckner brings to the table.
She does. And she's one of the nicest people out here. You always have a smile on her face. She'll always help anyone out that needs some help.
Possible 194 if she would strike out, which at least makes Anne-Marie show up for the 10th frame. Lane condition very close to what it was throughout the week. That's normally conducive to some pretty good matches, pretty good scores. And this hits a little bit light, so for Pam Buckner, it'll more than likely be a 5th place finish this week.
Which she can be very proud of. For not bowling full-time, it's very difficult, even for us who are out here every week to try and make a television show. You know, Pam had dropped to 10th at one point. She had been in 7th for quite a while and dropped to 10th and shot a 278 and moved up only to 9th. And she said, boy, what do you have to do to beat these kids? That was her thoughts in her mind at that time.
Said in the old days, I maybe would have jumped 2 or 3 spots, but not anymore. Cross lane, normally a very accurate spare shooter. It was a couple of chops that cost her an opportunity to move into game number 2 here tonight.
That's right. That made the difference of 20 pins, which is about what she's trailing by.
And Marie just looking to lock things up here in game number 1. Get loose. Start thinking about the next left hand. Good shot inside. 4-pin kicks right into the 9.
Good break, kicking the 4.
Anne-Marie with a possible 219, opts for a re-rack, the first in the championship round on lane 19.
The players are allowed 2 re-racks per game during the championship round.
Anne-Marie averaged 234 on the championship round pair, 214 for the event itself, and was 15-9 in match play.
It's a very good match play record. Those pins are very important, 30 pins per match that you win.
Anything over 500 anymore out here, as competitive as it is a good record. A little more room. Half 10 again. I think the question for Anne-Marie, Jan, will be, she can hit the pocket from in there, but what about the carry percentage? She doesn't seem to be throwing enough strikes to go up against maybe Dee Dee or Tish Johnson if they get hot.
Yeah, she's definitely not throwing enough strikes. I think right now she's probably changing hand positions, moving around a little bit, trying to find a better carry angle into the pocket that'll carry better for her.
And I think for Anne-Marie, as she expressed to us last night, she likes to play in a little bit more than, say, out near the gutter. She's a more comfortable player when she has a little area to work with.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And Anne-Marie has now locked up the match. Bess Pambuckner could shoot his 181.
And so for Anne-Marie, a free shot on lane 19. And she will advance to take on left-hander Dee Dee Davidson in game number two. Tish Johnson has qualified number two. And Cheryl Daniels, for the third time in her career, has nailed down the top seed position. Boy, looks like she's even deeper now on lane 19. Got a nice reaction there. So a solid game for Anne-Marie Dugan, a game of 199. A fifth place finish for WIBC Hall of Famer Pam Buckner. And a game that I'm sure that she'll remember for a good long time. One that kind of got away. Well, sure, it carries now. It always does. And we'll be back with game number two this week at Sam's Town in Las Vegas.